thought for the day, brothers and sisters. Today I was reading in the book of Leviticus, Leviticus chapter 25. We're in verses 8 to the end of the chapter, verse 55. We have what's called the Year of Jubilee. Basically, what that was when slaves, poor people were set free from the oppression and the debt that they owed to others. So today I wanted to speak on this topic of freedom. Today here in America, by the grace of God, on July 4th, 1776, America became a free nation, free from the oppression of England. Basically, this freedom back then was to be able to worship God. Religious freedom was very important, probably most important back then. However, today, some 200 years later, more than 200 years later, our nation has devolved into so much sin, freedom to do whatever you want. However, freedom, first and foremost, comes from Jesus Christ and Him alone as our Lord and Savior. In John chapter 8, verses 32 to 36, our Lord and Savior said, "If the Son of Man sets you free, you shall be free indeed." Freedom comes when the Holy Spirit resides in us. 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 17 speaks of that. Our Lord and Savior, when He started His ministry, when He came out of the wilderness, when He was tempted by the devil for 40 days in Luke chapter 4, He went to His hometown of Nazareth, and in verse 18, He opened up a scroll and said that the purpose for why He came on earth was to set the captives free. This was in fulfillment of the prophecy of Isaiah chapter 61, verse 1. This is real freedom, having Christ in your life, being free from your sins, being led by the Holy Spirit. This is why we're told in Galatians chapter 5, verses 13 and 14, that we have been set free not to indulge in our own flesh or our sinful desires, but to love one another, to serve others. Sadly, today, freedom in America has, as I said, where it's devolved into so much sin and rebellion against God. Free to do whatever you want. It seems like we're living in the days of the book of Judges. In Judges chapter 17, verse 6, Judges chapter 21, verse 25, the people were doing what was right in their own eyes. Today, we are living in these days here in America. I am free to do whatever I want. If I wanted to destroy a city and burn down a city, I'm free to do it. If I want to disrespect my parents or a police officer, or if I want to disrespect a teacher in school, I am free to do whatever I want with no repercussions. People are committing crimes today in America, especially in big inner cities, at record paces because now police officers' hands are tied. People can do whatever they want to do with no fear of the law, no fear of consequences. And so we are reaping what we are what we have sown. This is not what freedom is to look like. Freedom, as I said before, my brothers and sisters, is freedom from our sins. That's first and foremost. Freedom to die to self. As I said before in Galatians chapter 5, verse 13 and 14, freedom to die from our own sinful, proud, selfish motives and be led and filled with the Holy Spirit. This is what freedom really looks like. I hope today, my brothers and sisters, that we learn to be free in Christ, but not as a license to do whatever we want to do. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 12 tells us not everything that we have that is free is beneficial. We have to limit our freedoms, freedom to serve the Lord, freedom to love others, obey the word of God, live for Christ, be led by the Spirit. Yes, but not to be free to do what we want, because Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 9 says that the heart of man is deceitful. It is desperately wicked. If we are led by our heart to be free to do whatever we want, whatever's right in our own eyes, we will be living, as it says in Proverbs chapter 14, verse 12, there seems to be a right way towards man, what is right in his own mind and heart, but that way only leads to death. So I hope today, my brothers and sisters, we learn the consequences, the cost, and the benefits of true freedom. Heavenly Father, Lord God, I thank you for all my dear brothers and sisters in Christ. We'll see this devotional video on social media, Lord God. Father, I pray that we all would learn what it really means to be independent and free. Free to come to you, O Lord God, through your Son, Jesus Christ. Free to come to you, free of our sins, free of our own selfish desires. and to truly serve you, Lord God. That's what freedom really looks like, to be filled with your Holy Spirit. Father God, may many in our nation, many in the world, many in our churches and in our families learn what this true freedom really looks like. We ask these things in Jesus Christ, our dear Lord and Savior's name. Take care, my friends, my brothers and sisters today, and serve the Lord and be free in Him and Him alone.